Hello friends, this video is all about determinants of pro-social behavior. We as a human being frequently get engaged in pro-social behavior. What are the all determinants that decides how and why we engage in pro-social behavior? So in this video, we are going to discuss what are the determinants that are fundamentally responsible for human behavior, that is pro-social behavior. Why humans engage in pro-social behavior? Now let us start. What are the all determinants? Pro-social and cooperative behavior is the base for the evolution of human beings. It's a very clear from this statement that human beings evolved on the solid fundamentals of pro-social behavior. In short form, we'll call this PSB. So PSB ensures that human genes propagate so that human race survives. Through pro-social behavior, that is the reason, that is the answer of the question why that human beings engage in pro-social behavior. Because it ensures that human genes propagate. They propagate from one generation to next generation so that human race survives. For the sake of ensuring the survival of human beings, we ourselves engage in pro-social behavior. And it is very interesting that it is inborn trait and found in all human beings. We are need not to learn the pro-social behavior. The style of pro-social behavior may be different, that may be learned, but the concept, the initiative of pro-social behavior is inborn, and it is the style which differs, but the meaning behind the pro-social behavior remains the same, and that's why we call it as a pro-social behavior is inborn trait and not a learned trait. Next, there are broadly five determinants. We call it as a social determinants, personal determinants, cultural determinants, situational determinants, and social media. We'll discuss these determinants one by one. Now let us discuss social determinants. Every science is social enterprise. Very interesting concept. Walker 1969 said that whatever science we do, we experiment, or the results that comes out are purely social enterprise. So small example of this, that suppose you are engaged in a science experiment and you came out with an interesting product. If that product is accepted by the society as a whole or a people, that in that sense we call it the science, as your product is useful for the public, and that product will propagate and will sell. Similarly, if there is a product which is not accepted by the society or the people, in that case, that product is of no use. On the context of these two points, Walker has clearly said that science is a social enterprise. Let us discuss the first social determinant, social environment. The simple is the environment, the immediate environment, and physical settings and economic conditions just around us. This as a social environment. It is also one of the determinant of social behavior, pro-social behavior. Second is the social reinforcement. The governing of behavior by external events. External events mean outside your psyche. Reinforcement, the word has been given by Professor B.F. Skinner. This means that individual, through that reinforcement, tends to behave repeatedly if the reinforcement is positive. So what social reinforcement means? The governing of behavior by external events, that outside psych, such as pat on the back, a simple smile, simple praise for someone, acceptance, without any judgment and genuine paying genuine attention. These are the certain components that ensures the social enforcement. So it is also one of the social determinants. Third is social responsibility, the obligation to act for the welfare and benefit of society is termed as social responsibility. People who are found to be more socially responsible are have higher rate of pro-social behavior. Next is social justice, fair and just relations with society comes under the purview of social justice. What are that? Distribution of wealth must be fair. Equal opportunities and social equity, all these things combined together to make social justice, and it is also one of the social determinants of PSB. Social norms. Social norms are unwritten rules and regulations that governs the behavior of individuals. Yes, individuals are governed by certain rules and regulations which are not written at all. Still, people follow that. And that rules are called as social norms. This is also important determinant. Reciprocity. The act of paying back what an individual receives. You scratch my back, I will scratch your back, a famous maxim. Similarly, if someone pays you something, even a smile, that if the thing is intangible or tangible, individual also feels obligated to pay the individual back, and that is reciprocity. The next is social exchange. It is the exchange of activity. That activity might be tangible or intangible and more or less rewarding between at least two persons. Homans 1961 describes social exchange as such. Means any activity which can be tangible. Means if you help someone, that is intangible. If you give some gift, that is tangible. In that sense, and that activity must be rewarding. Individual must feel rewarded by that your activity. In that case, the individual who feels rewarded will certainly try to engage in social exchange more often. And if the individual engage in social exchange, that will inculcate and improve the inborn trait of pro-social behavior. Next is socio-economic status. These are social determinants, dear friends. At the individual level, one interesting thing, you can see this. At the individual level, lower socio-economic status participants show more PSB. Greve 2009 studied and found that people who are at the lower strata of SES are found to engage in more often pro-social behavior. So, dear friends, these were the social determinants of PSB. Now, let's go for personal determinants. Empathy. Empathy is the ability to understand and feel another person's emotions. It is the base for the PSB. I'll make it very clear what empathy means. Putting ourselves in other shoes means feelings and emotions of others. The curriculum of understanding, that is empathy. If someone is sad and if you feel and empathize with that individual and understand that the individual is due to some reason, and that reason, if it happens to me, I also become sad. So that individual is right in his or her feeling or emotion. If that feeling comes, emotions comes in an individual, that is called empathy. If someone is happy, there is a reason to be happy. So if you feel that that reason is sufficient for becoming happy, and that individual is right in expressing his or her happiness, this way we call as the individual is empathetic. So empathy is the ability to understand and feel another person's emotions. Moral reasoning. Thinking pattern. It's a type of thinking pattern, thought process to determine whether an idea is right or wrong. If an individual is high in a moral reasoning, he or she can very well, very clearly define whether that idea or the concept or the phenomena is whether right or wrong. And such people with high moral reasoning ability are found to be engaged in higher level of PSP. Mood, very interesting. Emotional concepts. Adrenaline, psychological state associated with emotions. It's a state. Sometimes your mood is good, you offer lift. Sometimes your mood is not good, you didn't offer lift. So mood is also a personal determinant for PSB. Emotions, a subjective, a relatively intense affective state. See, there are two, three things in this sentence which occurs in response to a stimulus and consciously experienced. One thing, it is subjective. No one can clearly measure it. It is a clearly subjective, relatively intense affective state which occurs due to some stimulus. That is the response to a stimulus, and that is experienced consciously. Means if I am feeling a happy state of emotions, I must be knowing that I am feeling happiness. Why I am explaining this way is that sometime if you smile someone, the other people will give a synthetic smile. That is not consciously experienced smile by the individual. If individual is smiling from inside, that state of smiling is different than synthetic smile. That is natural smile. So that is consciously experienced. So next is gender. A set of characteristics or traits that are associated with a certain biological sex. This is also very PSB, very important determinant of PSB. Physical attractiveness, specific physical features that solicit compulsive attention. It's a very interesting phenomenon. Individuals who are physically attractive, they are more likely to receive PSB, prosocial behavior. For example, if you are moving on your bike or your car, and if you find some attractive individual is asking for lift, it are higher chances that you are going to offer that individual your lift in your car. That is due to physical attractiveness. And internal joy and satisfaction. Dear friend, the psychological state of contentment and elation is called internal joy and satisfaction. This is also important personal determinant of prosocial behavior. Next, cultural determinants. Oh, one thing I want to make it very clear is that all cultures are prosocial. By default, every culture is prosocial across the board. So there is no reason to believe that particular culture is more prosocial, less prosocial. There may be difference in manifestation of prosocial behavior. Degree of prosocial behavior, magnitude of prosocial behavior may be different, but every culture is prosocial. It is very clear. Take first is cultural norms and tendencies, individualistic and collectivistic. Socialization practices that govern members' cultural behavior that are learned by observation and reinforcement, these are cultural norms and tendencies. There are certain cultures are individualistic. Certain are collectivistic. Individualistic cultures means individuals are given more prominence in that cultures. They think more about self. The norms, cultural norms are practiced individually, relatively. In the collectivist culture, where the assembly of people, they more focus on prosocial behavior, that their culture, their tendencies and their traditions are such that they propagate collectivist action. Western cultures are normally termed as individualistic cultures, whereas Eastern cultures are termed as collectivistic cultures. It's a very rough definition I have provided. You can study the books for deeper understanding of individualistic versus collectivistic. Next is cultural values, the criterion to judge an idea or behavior for being right or wrong, good or bad, just and fair. See, this is cultural value. Children of PSB families exhibit higher PSB orientation. This means if a parent or a family of an individual is more often engaged in cultural activities and pro-social behavior, the children of such families to exhibit higher pro-social behavior orientation. This is cultural determinants. So, third is cultural dimensions. The undeclared or unwritten boundaries drawn by society within which individuals are expected to behave or act. These are called cultural dimensions. There is no declared or certain tangible boundaries or written rules. They are unwritten. Still, individuals tend to behave within the limits of that. These are cultural dimensions. Dr. Hofstede, 1970, suggested six dimensions of culture, such as individualism versus collectivism or masculinity versus femininity, etc., etc. He said that these dimensions also influences the pro-social behavior. Cultural adaptation. The process of satisfactory integration into another culture is known as cultural adaptation. The individual who can easily adapt another culture are found to be engaged in more PSB, more pro-social behavior. So, dear friends, next is residential status, rural or urban. Rural people are more likely to offer help compared to urban one. Schroeder et al. 2015. Means people who are staying in the rural areas or rural background are found to be more often engaged in PSB. Religion. Religion-oriented people, any religious people, are found to be associated with greater charitable and volunteer activities, irrespective of demographic factors such as income and political orientation. Monsamar 2007. It is clear that religious people are more found to be associated with charitable and volunteer activities, means there are which are kind of pro-social behavior. See, the religion also an important personal determinant of PSB. Situational determinants. Needy person's degree of dependency. These are important. In a situation, an individual is asking for help. That degree of that asking for the help is a very important factor in soliciting the prosocial behavior from the bystanders. Those are looking for that. So, it is also an important factor. Kinship. The human relationship based on blood, marriage or adoption means the individuals are more likely to often engage in pro-social behavior to the individuals who are related in blood, marriage or they are being adopted as kinship. Then the situational motivators, the situation specific characteristics that motivate individuals for PSB. In a situation, individual decides whether to engage in PSB or not. That is dependent upon the motivators or the situational cues that are present at the situation. So, situational motivators also are important determinants. Then bystander effects, also known as diffusion of responsibility. That was an incident, Genovese syndrome, as you call it, as Kitty Genovese, a nurse returning after duty to her home, was brutally killed and raped by an individual. And almost 43 people were watching this incident. Then that process occurred more than 1 hour. But nobody took responsibility to call even police. Later, Latane and one of his colleagues studied this effect, why they failed to call. And they found out that it was due to bystander's effect. That is also known as diffusion of responsibility. A psychosocial phenomena where a person is less likely to engage in PSB in the presence of other individuals. That is called bystander effect. Situational behavior. The behavior exhibited by an individual in accordance with situation significantly affect PSP. Clear? Situational cues. The signals generated by a situation such as similarity, need, appearance, call for help, etc. also determines PSP. Individuals who are similar to us, they are more likely to engage in PSP, more likely to help. Those will judge the need of the individual. If the individual is in higher need, that also generates, solicits PSP. Appearance also is important. I already told you, physical attractiveness. Call for help. What is the gravity for the call of the help? The individual is more degree in call for help. In that case, the individual is more likely to receive the PSP. And the last is social media. The present-day social networking websites, popularly known as social media, have profound effect on PSP through observation, parental mediation, developmental factors, positive interaction, self-control, anti-stereotyping, and environmental awareness. So, social media is also, in nowadays, is a very, very important determinant of PSP. You call it observation. People observe through social media and less and likely to form a type of thinking pattern, whether to help that group or not. Similarly, parental mediation, and even parents mediate in using of social media. Then developmental factors also, and interaction with the people, what is your self-control, etc., an important determinants of PSP. Dear friends, these are the references from where I have taken these my material. You can cross-check them. And thank you, friends. We'll meet you shortly. And in the next video, this was all about determinants of pro-social behavior. If you have any suggestion or critical comments, you can kindly email to me on my email varmasojit@yahoo.com. I'll accept all your comments and try to improve in my next video. Thank you once again.